very good morning. You are watching New Vision TV News around Uganda. I am Raithina Suje, and here we look at stories making headlines across the country. We start off today's bulletin from Lira District. A jilted husband is being held at the Lira Central Police Station after he allegedly set the house of his mother-in-law ablaze, burning to death two children who were asleep in the house and destroying household property. The incident happened at around 10 p.m. on Friday at Quark Village, Agali sub-county in Erutu South, Lira District. Diko Dong, 42 years, is accusing his brother-in-law, Peter Adura, of the arson. Odong said Adura had earlier threatened to harm his family. Odong said his sister, Gloria Tino, a mother of two, returned home on December 26th following a domestic dispute with her husband, Adula. Adula went to his in-laws on Friday, demanding that Tino returns with him to his home. However, the family told him that she would only return after both families had resolved the dispute. Moving on to Ntungamo District, as Ruhama residents prepare to go to polls on Thursday, National Resistance Movement bigwigs have pitched camp in the area to camp for the party's flag bearer, Moses Mugabe Kahima. While campaigning in Nyachira sub-county at Ngoma Parish headquarters on Saturday, Kahima vowed to defeat his rival Ingenia Jackson Mubangizi Kabakire. Kahima called on voters to shun Kabakire, who is contesting as an independent candidate after losing during the recent NRM primaries. He said his opponent is being defiant towards the party. Therefore, the voters cannot have him represent them when there is an NRM flag bearer. He promised to work with the former Ruhama MP and the current NRM Ntungamo district chairperson, Janet Museveni, and other district leaders to develop the area. Now moving on to Yumbe District, the leaders have taken stringent measures to arrest people involved in illegal tree-cutting and selling. Led by the resident district commissioner, Manasseh Wadia, who heads the district security team with support from the district forest department, the group have resorted to impounding vehicles from carrying logs cut by natural tree species. Speaking to the New Vision over the weekend, Wadia said several trucks have been seen ferrying logs, mostly Africana, a tree species which takes 300 years to mature. He said these rare tree species bring a lot of rain, and once destroyed, replacement takes decades to grow. Finally, from Mukabali District, researchers at the Kachwekano Zone Agricultural Research and Development Institute, Kazadi, in Kabali District, have bred an Irish potato variety resistant to late blight disease. The new variety was incorporated with a gene from the wild potato from the Adrian potato gene pool in South America that was developed by the International Potato Center. Late blight destroys the leaves and stems of Irish potato. Dr. Alex Bariche, the director of research at Kazadi, told farmers at the institute on Saturday the region is potential to produce the Irish potato was being hampered by the diseases that led to loss of up to 60%. Patrick Besigye, the Kabali district chairperson, said their hope was in the scientists doing more research on the Irish potato. And that's all we had for you. Thank you for watching. Be sure to catch more news updates and other programs here on New Vision TV by visiting our website www.newvision.co.ug. I am Rorethi Naseje.